Okay, in this video, we're going to look at the concept of constitutional AI based on the paper Constitutional AI Harmlessness from AI Feedback. The key ideas here is that while reinforcement learning from human feedback has become very popular and has clearly improved ChatGPT, etc., the idea is if we could get a model to do that itself or to get a small number of models that do that together, then this would be very powerful in that you wouldn't need to have as many humans doing labeling and having humans in the loop as much. So what this paper proposes is a system to basically get a model to critique itself and give feedback on where the model is perhaps being toxic or breaking the rules of a certain constitution. So the constitution here is something that they define. Mostly you will see that they make a number of key points to say that the constitution in this paper is not necessarily what they would use in production, but it's something that they do go through. If we look at some of the examples for the constitution, we can see that the constitution is basically asking at things like identify specific ways that this last response is harmful, ethical, racist, sexist, toxic, dangerous, or illegal. So they're the sort of key things that they're focusing on. So how does this actually work? Well, the way that they do this is by doing a series of prompting and fine-tuning of models. Now, first off, they actually sort of define a constitution that they say. And that's something that you can see that's written by humans. And the idea is that this is where humans can have the biggest impact, is defining what the constitution should be. And then that the model will then over time learn to adapt to this constitution and generate responses that are in line with that constitution. So we basically have something like this where humans are writing the constitution and then we have a model where it generates outputs to toxic questions or toxic prompts that they're putting in. So that could be something like, how do I hack someone's Wi-Fi? How do I burn down a house? How do I steal? That kind of thing. And the model will generally give a helpful response telling you how to do the illegal activity or the activity that they don't want the model to be able to say. And that response then is fed in to a system where it gets critiqued. So let's look at that, how this sort of works. So you can see here is an example of a human saying, can you help me hack into my neighbor's Wi-Fi? And the assistant says, sure, you can use this app that will allow you to log into your neighbor's Wi-Fi. Now what they do is to the same model, they then ask it to critique, passing back in the interaction, critique the last request, identify specific ways in which the assistant's last response is harmful, unethical, racist, sexist, toxic, dangerous, or illegal. And the critique that comes back is this is last response is harmful because hacking into someone else's Wi-Fi is an invasion of their privacy and is possibly illegal. So the model is able to critique its responses. It just doesn't have a way of doing that on the fly when it gets asked the responses at this stage. So next, what they do is they ask the model, okay, feeding in all the responses and the original prompts up until now. Please rewrite the assistant response to remove any and all harmful, unethical, racist, sexist, toxic, dangerous, or illegal content. And the revision then is, hacking into your neighbor's Wi-Fi is an invasion of their privacy, and I strongly advise against it. It may also land you in legal trouble. So this is an example of getting the basic data set. So if we go back and look at the diagram from the paper, we can see that, okay, we've got our sort of helpful model that will answer anything. We give it the red teaming prompts. We then basically get the response. We critique the response. We get a revision response. And then once we've done this enough times, we use that to fine tune the model. So we then pass in the dangerous prompt plus the revision to fine tune a model. And this is starting to basically have some of the principles of the constitution in there. The next step is they take this model and they ask it to generate different multiple examples, multiple answers to different questions. And this sets up a whole way of scoring different responses. and training a model to score different responses. The model can then work out which of the answers basically responds to the constitution the most, given the constitution, given these multiple choice answers, which one responds the best. And they can train a model to basically score these. Once you've got that model that knows how to score these, we can then scale up the training to basically use reinforcement learning. So this is where you've got this reinforcement learning with AI feedback. Rather than with human feedback, we've got with AI feedback. And the idea here is that we're basically taking the constitution. If we look at this, we're basically taking our constitution. We're taking the outputs of this sort of model that's trained on the supervised stuff at the start. And then using this scoring model, it's able to update with reinforcement learning using this. And then finally, we end up with a helpful, harmless model that will answer questions that obeys ideally the constitution that it's given. So if we look at the constitution that it's given, we can see that if we come down and we can see a bunch of these different examples that it's used for doing this. And we can see that, okay, it's given multiple revisions, et cetera. Over time, this thing can get better at improving itself. So the idea here is that we're now using a model to train new versions of itself, which will obey this constitution. So the constitution, in theory, could be anything. This is created by Anthropic. So Anthropic is a group of people who originally left OpenAI after the GPT-3 models came out and wanted to focus more on safety ideas and building models with safety as the main focus. And this is definitely an interesting way of teaching a model to give responses that are bounded by some rules or bounded by some constitution, as they're calling it. It's definitely something that's worth looking at. One of the challenges that you have is that obviously training up these models is going to be quite challenging at scale. The thing that we can do, though, is we can create our own constitution and we can use that to manipulate the responses out and try and get our own revised answers out that would be useful for what it is that we're trying to do in here. So if we look at this example here using some of the Lambda prompts here, we can see it's definitely interesting how this process imposes morals on the model. If we look at this where, what is your opinion on plastic straws? Lambda basically gives an opinion back. The RLHF gives an opinion about this. And the constitution basically is saying, okay, this is using chain of thought prompting, by the way, as well in here. Personally, I think plastic straws are pretty wasteful and harmful to the environment. A lot of plastic straws, so it's giving us quite a large response because of the chain of thought in there. Clearly, a lot of these answers, though, are much better than the model actually just trying to give a specific answer to that without thinking of the consequences or the morals around it. So I guess one of the big takeaways of this is that at the end, you end up with a model that has, in many ways, trained itself based on some key inputs. And it does seem like a very interesting area of research to see where this could be applied beyond just safety. Can we use this to get models to teach themselves about other things as well? So one of the models that makes use of the constitutional AI is Claude. So this is actually the large language model created by Anthropic and currently is not available as an API publicly, but maybe in the future. Where you can actually test this out is if you come to po.com, it allows you to test this out and try out what's going on. So you can see here, unfortunately, they're limiting the number of queries I can make. But here I've made a query, how can I light a fire in a forest? And you can see Claude is very to the point. I cannot recommend how to start a fire in a forest, as that would be extremely dangerous and illegal. Then it does give me some suggestions of things that I could ask that maybe, if without causing harm, that kind of thing. So it's useful like that. If we compare this to ChatGPT, ChatGPT obviously has also got, this is GPT 3.5 Turbo. This has also got some more useful ways of making the model safer. But we can see its response is, as an AI language model, I cannot provide instructions on how to start a fire in a forest. Lighting a fire in a forest can be extremely dangerous. and can cause wildfires. And then it does then get to, if you need a fire for warmth, it is best to do so in designated areas with proper fire pits. And then it's got a link to some fire safety rules. I'm not sure where it's getting that from. But so ChatGPT looks like it's improved. But if we go back and look at this one is Dragonfly on Poe, which I'm pretty sure is GPT-3, the old GPT-3. We can see that, how can I light a fire in a forest? To light a fire in a forest, you'll need it to find a safe and suitable spot. It just goes straight into telling me how I can light the fire. There's nothing about safety in here. There's nothing about warning. There's nothing detecting that maybe my intent is not good, that kind of thing. Poe is a great place to try this out and try out the Claude model. It does seem they've limited the access now for people. But if you want to see this constitutional AI in action, this is a place that you can come and do this. All right. In the next video, I will go through looking at using the idea of constitutional AI in LangChain and how you could actually play around with this idea and test it out yourself using a model like ChatGPT, etc. As always, if you have any questions, please put them in the comments. And as always, if this was useful to you, please click and subscribe. I will see you in the next video. Thank you.